If you think that the M1 is a PC chip killer, you're wrong. It's close, but what's coming after is gonna blow your mind completely. If you've been following fellow YouTubers and other nerdy tech portals, you've seen the benchmark results, as well as the reviews of M1 and comparisons. But we should not stop there. The latest news from Bloomberg suggests we can expect some new monsters sooner than we expected. And oh boy, we're gonna talk about it. Before we do the intro and get to the point, would you still buy Intel-based Mac or no? Please answer in the comment section below. Now let's go. Hi guys, and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco, and this is your weekly fix of tech news, leaks, rumors and opinions, everything about Apple and their competitors. If you're fond of this type of content, subscribe now, leave a comment below, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable notifications so you don't miss the next video. Even if it may seem that PC industry and CPU manufacturers are in trouble, namely Intel, you know that's not true, not yet. I mean, Apple did showcase how far the ARM architecture can go, but it will depend from other companies like Microsoft, AMD, even Intel, which path they will choose. Recent rumors reveal that AMD, for example, will be ready to challenge Apple's M1 chip. Remember that AMD is also doing business with TSMC. That means 5-nanometer production node is also available to them as well. Yet, for average Windows users, that would not mean a lot of difference. And that's nothing new, because they normally don't care about the Macs. And if you don't believe me, just check these numbers below and you'll see why. However, what Apple is doing here in the long run has a potential to completely shake the industry, and for better or worse, may urge other companies to follow their direction. Let's be honest, after years of planning and development, Apple Silicon is fascinating. This makes you wonder what kind of a beast will come next year, and how it may compare to well-established rulers of x86 and 64 space. While there is no doubt that predicted improvements, like adding more CPU cores, 12, 16, or even 32, is a logical step forward, and probably increase of unified memory, there is one thing that can really push the limit far beyond, and that is better graphics. If you remember initial analysis, Apple's M1 8-core GPU, at least on benchmarks, seem comparable, and in some instances even better than a couple of dedicated graphic cards, which for the firstborn Apple GPU is mostly impressive. Even real-world performance has proven to go above expectations, regardless if it was with 8 or 16 gigs of unified memory. Now funny, if you look online, there is not a lot of information about the unified memory, except for a couple of explanations how this thing works. You can barely find something beyond that. It's almost like Apple caught the industry off guard, or worse, with pens down. Apparently, according to Bloomberg, Apple is already working on the next generation in-house silicon. For those hungry of more graphical power, you guys are in luck. It appears that folks from Cupertino are testing 16 and 32 core GPUs, which will, as article states, will be reserved for mid-range iMacs and high-end MacBooks. But the real stuff is coming for those machines that are on the top of the food chain. Mac Pro, which is ready for redesign and most likely much smaller form factor, like 2 times smaller. And it seems like that Apple is pushing really hard, already testing 64 and even 128 core GPUs. My God! With so much power, Apple could challenge everything in CPU and GPU industry. I mean, literally, these numbers are insane. To go so far and so quickly just makes you wonder, and then what? What comes after? How many CPU cores? How much unified memory? How many graphics cores? And what about the frequency? Are we patient enough to wait? When will that happen? First, if you've seen one of my previous videos, I said that Apple at this moment doesn't need any upgrades above standard M1 chip. It can deal with any kind of task. I was definitely wrong. If Bloomberg's report is accurate, Apple is aiming for 2021, 2022, the most. I'm talking about mid-range and high-end computers, and that's gonna be crazy. So now, if you weren't sure, should you buy a new M1 Mac or should you wait, you will most definitely be encouraged to wait a little more. Now, before you decide to go in that direction, keep in mind that Apple will release smaller or bigger upgrades all the time, every year, sometimes even a couple of times per year. There will always be something new to wait for. So if you find any of the current models fit to your needs, don't waste time. In a year, two or maybe three, you'll do your refresh again. That's all from me for this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up, leave a comment and subscribe. Thank you for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye. The latest news from Bloomberg.